Hi friends, I hope that you are doing well and you and your family continue to do well. So on that note, let's begin today's current affairs, that is for May 19, 2021. But before that, if you're coming here for the first time, then do not forget to subscribe our channel and hit the bell notification. Also, this is the Telegram group which you can join to get your queries resolved or if you want to directly connect with your mentors. Guys, this is the 2022 course where we provide you with PDFs, videos and mock tests. Apart from this, you will also get the interview preparations. So we conduct mock interviews under which we will be taking your interviews and providing you with guidance regarding your interviews. Next is that if you enroll in this course, you will get a book kit that includes these books. And right now there is a discount of 30% on this course, which you can avail by using RBI30 coupon code. Now this number is for your help, guys. If you want to get your get help regarding the course syllabus or eligibility or anything else, then you can just give us a call on this number. Okay, so let's begin the current affairs for today with this first question. Where is India's first agriculture export facilitation center established? So we have 5 cities. All of them are from Maharashtra. Now which one is the right answer? You have Nagpur, Amravati, Aurangabad, Pune, Nashik. Out of these 5 options, the right answer is option D, that is Pune. So in Pune, Maharashtra, this Agriculture Export Facilitation Center has been established, and this is the first of its kind in India that such kind of export facilitation center has been established for agricultural produce. Now the purpose of this center is to promote the agriculture's goods or agri produce in the state of Maharashtra. So basically the goods produced in the state of Maharashtra will be promoted, and the training will be provided, training, guidance, information related to the export and central schemes that have been launched to promote export. So these kinds of information, these kinds of guidances and export related training will be provided to the stakeholders in Maharashtra. So that is the main purpose of this export facilitation center, agriculture export facilitation center. So I hope that I'm clear to you guys, and if there is any doubt, you can just ask it in the comment section below. Okay, the next question is, what is the theme of UN Global Road Safety Week 2021? You have 5 options. Speak up to save lives, improving global road safety, leadership for road safety, save lives, slow down, streets for life. So out of these 5 options, the right answer is option E, streets for life. That is the theme of UN Global Road Safety Week 2021. Now this week is observed from 17th May to 23rd May. So these are the dates of this week, UN Global Road Safety Week. Guys, my question from you is that, can you tell me that when did India celebrate National Road Safety Month in 2021? This is your question. You have to mention in the comment section below. Next question is, who has won the International Invincible Gold Medal 2021? So again, we have 5 names. Meenakshi Legi, Shashi Tharoor, Urvashi Bhutalia, Ramesh Pokhriyal Nishank, Kirti Jaikumar. I think the answer is not very difficult to guess even. The right answer is option D, Ramesh Pokhriyal Nishank, who is the education minister as well at the present time. Now he has been given this award in order to recognize his efforts, he recognizes contribution towards society by way of his books or his poems or whatever work he has done in the field of literature. So basically, his contribution towards society through his works has been recognized by giving him this International Invincible Gold Medal 2021. Now, which organization gives this award? Maharishi Organization Worldwide is the name of the organization that gives this International Invincible Gold Medal. So that was all about this question. Now we are moving on to the next question. Who has won the men's singles at the Italian Open 2021? So this is an important question, guys. We have 5 tennis players right in front of us, and out of these 5, the right answer is option D, Rafael Nadal. Now guys, Nadal belongs to Spain. His nationality is Spanish. Do remember that. And currently he is the world number 3 tennis player. So his position is number 3 in the ATP ranking. ATP ranking is basically the ranking of tennis players provided by Association of Tennis Players. So this is the association for men's tennis players. Now that was all about Rafael Nadal. Do remember this thing that he's the number 3 in the world tennis ranking, and Novak Djokovic is the person who has topped that one. Now, apart from the men's singles, we also have women's single in Italian Open that has been won by Iga Swiatek. So she is from Poland. So she is the Polish tennis player, and currently she is ranked at the 9th position in the WTA ranking. Now, WTA stands for Women's Tennis Association. So that ranks Iga Swiatek at the 9th position among the top world tennis women's tennis players. Who is the person that has topped this women's tennis players list? It is Ashleigh Barty. So she is the one that has topped this ranking. Now guys, your task is to tell me the nationality of Novak Djokovic as well as Ashleigh Barty in the comment section below. Moving on to the next question. Recently, India renewed its cultural exchange program with the country till 2023. Now we have Afghanistan, Mongolia, Philippines, Thailand and Maldives in the options. Out of these 5 options, Mongolia is the right answer. So with Mongolia, this cultural exchange program was established in 2015. And now it has been renewed till the year 2023. Okay, now apart from this, under this cultural exchange program only, India is going to offer 10 scholarships to the Mongolian students so that they can study in the centers, in the specific Buddhist centers located in India. So particularly 2 centers have been chosen for this scholarship. Now which 2 centers are these? So the first center is Central Institute for Buddhist Studies, Leh, and second is Central Institute for Higher Tibetan Studies in Varanasi. So 10 dedicated scholarships for the Mongolian students have been provided so that they can study in these 2 centers in India under this cultural exchange program. Now apart from this, guys, you should also know this thing that Indian Council for Cultural Relations is the autonomous organization under Ministry of External Affairs that is responsible for maintaining India's cultural relationship with the other countries. So basically this is the country, this is the organization that is heading this cultural exchange program. So that was all about this news. My question from you is that you have to tell me the capital and currency of Mongolia in the comment section below. So that was all about this video. I hope that you have enjoyed it, and if you have, then do not forget to subscribe our channel and hit this bell notification. Also guys, you can share this video and like it as well. Thank you so much.